Hey, what's up, Advertising Boost members? In this video, I'm gonna be showing you guys how to automate the process of delivering your vacation vouchers using a messenger bot. All right, so in order to automate this process, you're gonna need three things, all right? So you're going to need a Google Sheet, all right? Basically, all you're gonna have to do is, if you have a Google account set up, you're gonna set up a Google Sheet in order to export the information into that Google spreadsheet so that Zapier recognizes which vacation vouchers to send out. All right, second thing you're gonna want to use is of course Zapier. All right, Zapier is basically that tool that's going to grab the information from your messenger bot into your Google Sheet, and then it's going to send it over to the Advertising Boost integration, which takes me to my third point. The third tool that you're going to need is the Advertising Boost integration. I'm going to walk you guys through on how to get that set up. It's a private invitation within the Advertising Boost group, and so you're going to want to accept that invite so that you can use the Advertising Boost integration inside of Zapier. So let's jump on in. Hey, what's up, you guys? All right, so here we are. We're gonna get started. I just previewed the message. We're gonna get started on going through the messenger bot. Please keep in mind that I did set up this bot for tutorial purposes. Everything on the back end is already set up, but of course, if you know, your messaging is probably gonna be different if you know, whatever, based on whatever your niche is, okay? So again, I set this up for tutorial purposes to show you guys how to automate the process from messenger bot to a Google Sheet to deliver the either whether it's a vacation voucher or the hotel voucher. So we're gonna start off right here. First thing that this thing is asking us is it's going to ask us for our email, okay? Inside ManyChat, you do have the option to auto-populate the email. But again, sometimes people, when they're gonna receive their voucher, you know, it's a strong enough offer to where they're not gonna give you a wrong or a fake email. Sometimes they may give you even a better email, and sometimes the email that's provided within Facebook that auto-populates into the messenger may be a different email that they may not prefer. So I like to go this route and just have them type in the email. Hasn't never been an issue. First thing it's going to ask is the email, then it's going to move on to the next step, and now it's going to go to set them up to select their destination. Okay, so perfect. Now click the view destinations button to choose your honeymoon. So here it is. Now it's going to present that the end user with all the options that, you know, Advertising Boost has to offer. It's all going to be presented here as you know, different photos of the different places that you can go to: Thailand, US, and Mexico. So we're going to go ahead, and I'm just going to continue running through this. I'm going to go ahead and select on Thailand, and I am going to pick, here's a list of destinations, and now it's going to provide the list. Okay, so there's Koh Samui, Bali, and Phuket. Okay, so I'm going to go with Koh Samui. All right, here we are. And now it's just going to give you a picture where it spent 7 nights, and now it's going to give the person the option to claim the offer. Okay, so now it's going to say claim offer, and I like to make sure that the person is going to, you know, that they're set, they are going to select Koh Samui, because they're not going to have a second option. They don't have the option to, hey, I don't want to go to Koh Samui, I actually want to change my mind, I want to go to a different one. If you do want to do that, that's fine. But again, I like to just confirm that this is the one that they're going to do. So you selected Koh Samui, Thailand. Please type Koh Samui. And now we are going to type Koh Samui. And as soon as that goes, then everything gets sent over to a Google Sheet. Okay, so now, perfect angel, we hope you will enjoy Koh Samui. Use the button below and we will send you your voucher via email. Okay, so this is just the run. I'm gonna jump into like the back end of what you guys want to make sure that you have set up so that this thing gets all exported out to a Google Sheet, and then it automates the delivery of the voucher you know, via Zapier. So as soon as they click this button, they're gonna click this button, and everything gets exported out to a Google Sheet. Okay, so here it is right here. It all got sent over to my Google Sheet. So it collected my name, it collected my email, it collected my user ID, and the name of the destination, and then the code, okay? If you're not familiar with where the code is, you can find the code inside your Advertising Boost portal, and then, of course, the date that I last interacted with the Messenger bot, okay? So now I'm gonna jump into the ManyChat platform to show you guys how or the crucial parts that you wanna have set up so that everything works properly and it delivers the information over to the Google Sheet, okay? So this is what the flow looks like. Of course, this is what, you know, all the pictures that you saw over here. Nope, you saw that over here. These are all the pictures. So you see the cards here, you see the list. That's all set up on that, on this flow right here. Okay, so now when they go and they select, let's say I selected Koh Samui, which is probably this one right here. Okay, we'll just say it's this one. This is Koh Samui. So you saw the button, the claim offer button, right? Which was this right here. That's what that it looks like set up on the back end. Oops. Looks like it failed. All right, let's go back. My computer looks like it's dropped that one right there. Okay, so we're gonna jump back. This is what it looked like. We're gonna hit that claim offer button. And now this is what it's gonna do, okay? So when it says, when it finds the claim offer button, it's gonna send a message back saying to claim the offer, right? So you're gonna have a keyword set up. This keyword is the Koh Samui. So if you remember from over here, it said, you selected Koh Samui, Thailand for your honeymoon. Please type Koh Samui, Thailand to confirm. Okay, so now we are gonna jump back here. And this is what that looked like on the back end, okay? So it said, it sent them the message, and now it's going to say, once they select that option, it said, perfect, Angel. We hope you would enjoy Koh Samui. And now it's going to, perfect, we hope you enjoy Koh Samui. And now here it is. So let's open up the edit. And I do have some, you know, rules set in place that if any of these people meet any of these following conditions, like if they've already previously gone and tried to download one of these options, it won't let them, okay? So if ManyChat will recognize that somebody have already downloaded an option, and if they have met that option, it's gonna tell them, hey, first name, we can only send out one voucher right now. If you know somebody or anybody else that can use our services, we would be happy to send you on another trip. All right, so if ManyChat recognizes that that person has downloaded a voucher previously, it's gonna tell them that we can't send another one right now, okay? And if not, if this is the first time they've gone through this, this is the very crucial part that you wanna have in place. You're gonna set a custom field that when this person clicks this button, you're gonna wanna set a custom field, okay? So set the custom field, and you're gonna set this one, me personally, I set it as downloaded voucher, and then the value is going to be 13, okay? Because 13 is the code for Koh Samui Indonesia. If this was, you know, let's just say this was Cancun, which is, I believe it's number one, you're gonna set that custom field to downloaded voucher, and then you're gonna set the value to one, okay? So of course, each destination has its own flow, okay? So let's say, for example, again, if this was Cancun, that custom field is going to be downloaded voucher, and then it's gonna be one, okay? That's crucial. You guys need to have that in place, all right? Because that button right there, that custom field, is what we're gonna look for inside of Zapier to export the information over to the Google Sheet. Okay, so here we are now. I had already previously set it up just to test it, make sure it's running. We're gonna run through it one more time. So again, our first step is gonna be ManyChat. This is gonna be the trigger button, okay? We're gonna look for a new or updated custom field. I'm gonna select my page, which is the one that we are testing the tutorial from. And here it is. So this is what ManyChat or Zapier is gonna look for in order to trigger the Zap, okay? So it's gonna look for downloaded voucher. Oh, we already have it set, but so this is what it'll look like. So downloaded voucher, okay? I'm just kind of going through it as if this was the very first time. And here I am right here. So this is my name, and this is the information that I input, Koh Samui, and then the code 13, okay? So we are going to continue. And now we're gonna select a spread, we're gonna send this over to a Google spreadsheet. Okay, I always recommend sending everything to a spreadsheet just so you have like a backup to keep track of, you know, how many people are downloading the voucher at this point, okay? So we're gonna select spreadsheet. We're going to do create spreadsheet row, okay? So continue. You're gonna select the account that you have the spreadsheet from, okay? So I have it under that account. And now we are going to find the spreadsheet. All right, so I labeled this spreadsheet test sheet. Of course, I have several other spreadsheets set up here. We're gonna find test sheet. You're gonna select that one. And now this is gonna be the name of the worksheet. Okay, so down here, I labeled this AB vacation voucher. This is the name of the worksheet inside of my spreadsheet, okay? So the name of the worksheet is AB vacation voucher. We're gonna select that one, and it's gonna pull up, here, let me actually just pull up a different one to see so that you guys can actually see what it looks like. All right, so now it's gonna look like that. Of course, there's nothing. All right, so let me go back. We're gonna click on test sheet. And now we're gonna click on AB vacation voucher. And you have to have these headers set up. Otherwise, it's not gonna pull all these fields down here, okay? You have to have the headers, name, email, user ID. I highly recommend you set that up inside your Google Sheet because you wanna keep track of those user IDs. The destination name, which is in this case, Koh Samui, and then the destination code, number 13, okay? And then date created, which is the last time that user interacted with your messenger bot. Okay, which was at this time. Now we go back to the Zap, and now we're gonna start. I'm just gonna delete all these so that we can start this from scratch. So now we're gonna start plugging in the information, populate the information back into these fields. Okay, so we're gonna pull this from ManyChat. All right, so here's the username, the full name. Here is the email that I provided at the very first part of the flow. You're just gonna scroll down and find it. So here it is. You save that email to a custom field. Let me just kind of go back to that part really quick so that you make sure you input that part. So it's this one. So when that person provided the email, so let's cover some details. What email would you like for us to send it? Send your honeymoon voucher. Okay, you're gonna save that response. All right, this is the user input option. Okay, so I use the user input option as opposed to just the text. So if you just do a text, you won't be able to save, or you can, but the best and fastest way to do it at this point is to use the user input option to save this email to the custom field. Okay, so you would go in here, you would save the response to a custom field, and this one's labeled current customer email. All right, you can just name it vacation email or however you want to name it. You want to make sure that you save that to a custom field, okay? And that's how it's going to pull that information over here. All right, so that email, if you look back, it was saved as down here, current customer email. So there it is right there. And now we're going to pull the user ID. And now we're going to pull the destination name, which is user custom field honeymoon, claimed honeymoon Thailand. All right, and that is set up over here. So we're gonna open this up, we're gonna open up this flow, and that is set right here, okay? So when they click this button, when they click Koh Samui Thailand to claim this one, it's going to, here, let's open up the actions. All right, so here it is. So we're gonna, again, we're gonna set that custom field to, hey, this person claimed honeymoon, the name of the custom field is honeymoon, and then we're gonna set the value as Koh Samui Thailand. All right, another crucial piece that you make sure you need to have in place for each one that they select, or for each one that's available. Okay, so if you see down here on this one, for example, this one is set as This custom field is set as claimed honeymoon, and then we have Phuket, Thailand, okay? So you're gonna wanna have that those custom fields set for each one of those, all right? Set custom field, claimed honeymoon, and then Bali, Thailand, all right? So let's just click on one more. This is Las Vegas. And now claimed honeymoon, you're gonna set the value as Las Vegas, Nevada. All right, so that's how Zapier is gonna know which destination name to pull. And then you're just gonna go, if you remember that was set, the custom field was claimed honeymoon. And then we're just gonna find that custom field down here, which there it is, claimed honeymoon, Koh Samui, Thailand, which is the one that I originally selected. All right, and now we're gonna select the destination code, which if you remember at this point, we'll just go back to my flows, let that load. Keyword. Which over here, if you remember here, we set this downloaded voucher to 13. Okay, so you're gonna, now we need the code. All right, so we need the code to populate in there because we're gonna need that code when we send the voucher. So now we're gonna find that custom field, downloaded voucher. There it is, or there it is right there. So downloaded voucher number 13. And then the last time that they interacted was down here. So you're gonna scroll all the way down and you'll find user last interaction. And then we'll put in that time right there. So now we're gonna continue. And if we send this test, see it's gonna send all that information right over to my Google Sheet. And now we're gonna continue. Okay, so now we're gonna add another action of sending out the vacation voucher. Okay, so at this point here, we're gonna start from the beginning. So you're gonna search advertising boost, vacation incentive, and we're going to continue. Test, make sure that's connected. Here, let me just kind of delete all these so that we can start this from scratch, okay? All right, so the business name, of course, this is gonna pull from the business names that you have set up inside of your Advertising Boost portal, okay? So I'm gonna select that one. We are gonna pull the name from ManyChat, okay? This is the name of the user who claimed the honeymoon. All right, we're gonna pull their email as well. If you scroll all the way down to find current customer email, which is what we saved it as, current customer email right there. And then now at this part, this is the part where you need to have the Google Sheet actually at this part, because you're gonna need to pick up this code right here. You can't just set this as, Nuevo Vallarta, because every single time that somebody goes in through this, or anytime that this zap triggers, it's only gonna send them Nuevo Vallarta. Or if you have Cancun, it's only gonna send them Cancun. It's not gonna be, accordingly to what that person selects. So what we need to do here is we find the drop-down menu, we pull this all the way down, and we need to use a custom value, okay? Custom value, and now at this part, this is where we're gonna pull the information from the Google Sheet. So if we pull the information from the Google Sheet, we're gonna find destination code. All right, so now every single time that there's a new row that's added in here, it's gonna pull that new code accordingly to what that person selected, right? So if, let's say, Jeff Bob comes in here, you have his email, you have his user ID, you have the name of the destination, let's just say Cancun, and that's gonna populate number one, okay? Because we have that set up for those custom fields inside ManyChat. That's gonna populate number one and then the date. All right, so now every single time that this changes, it's just gonna pull the information from this column right here, all right? So you need to have that custom value and pull the information from the Google Sheet. So now we're gonna continue. And now we're just gonna send the test to Advertising Boost, or to our email, and we finish.
So there it is, guys, the full tutorial on automating your process of delivering your vacation vouchers via your Messenger bot, okay? So remember, you want to have those custom fields in place to collect the emails, to collect the names of the destinations, and to have those codes accordingly to the names of the destinations. Okay, remember, you can grab those codes over from the Advertising Boost portal and match those codes so that they deliver and they export out into the Google Sheet and the proper vacation voucher is delivered to the end user. Also, keep in mind, this Messenger bot can be used for all service-based businesses. You can, if you're a photographer, if you're a wedding photographer, videographer, if you're a hairstylist, a barber, any service-based business, you can apply this same technique, this same flow into your business. All right, so there it is, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll talk to you guys soon.